In addition, as noticed by these authors, Garreau and Morin, 1991, 1992, we conclude also that the opening was done on a mobile zone of the crust in Tunisia, more precisely on a submeridian fault, inherited from the African craton. Finally, the SWNE detected extension originates from the rifting and oceanic activity in Northern Basin, Tethyan Western Branch, and the Eastern Basin, Tethyan Southernmost Branch, Messagia, Dercourt et al., 1985, Martinez and Trulet, 1987, Riku, 1994, Stampley et al., 2002, Chedino and Scatis, 2002. In this context, the northern margin behaves like a strike-slip margin, Gibraltar-Messine transform fault, from the Upper Liassic onwards, while the eastern margin represents a classical passive margin that takes over from or develops alongside the transcurrent shear zone from the early/late Cretaceous boundary, Figure 6. A. Simplified geological and structural map of El Hamra El Ayert area and stereographic plots of faults, equal area, lower hemisphere. Slick inside lineations are shown by small arrows. Black arrows, direction of extension, Riggan et al., 2010. B. Interpretation of the study area, two negative lozenge-shaped depocenter bounded by a NS shear zone, Riggan et al., 2010. The Parisian limestones, in central area or Tunisia, are cut up by normal dip-slip and strike-slip faults of late Parisian age. All these fractures are arranged mainly in submeridian N060, EW and N140 directional systems. The first, the commonest and the most pronounced associates locally according to sectors with the other systems to form reedal type, pull-apart or horst and graben structures. The detailed structural analysis of these Parisian limestones clearly shows that this period is characterized by normal fault and extensive strike-slip fault movements. The normal and or strike fault throw vary from a few centimeters to a few meters and evolve laterally into a flexure. Geodynamic context of Tunisian basin from Jurassic to the end of Lower Cretaceous, after Martinez et al. 1987, modified. The results obtained from the different measures carried out for each system and their processing show that the finite Eurasian faulting event is the result of two successive episodes, very close in time, Figure 7. They are characterized first by a NWSE extension, Episode 1, followed by a SWNE extension, Episode 2. The geometric and kinematic study of this area clearly indicates that, during late Eurasian, there was a remobilization of ancient fractures, mainly submeridian and NWSE, in an extensive strike-slip context. Quantitative analysis of terminal accretion striated slick insides revealing the two strain sequences and their directions of extension in central Tunisia. 1. Schmidt pattern, lower hemisphere, 2. Strike slip fault, 3. Normal fault, 4, 5, 6. Major axes of the stress tensor, 7. Direction of extension. Extensive structures, normal faults, normal strike slip faults and flexures, appeared and evolved in this context within the Ousseltia block, Figure 8, which, therefore, presented, at that time, a mainly vertical mobility the origin of which stays in the basement. This mobility results in extensive structures in the basin. The corresponding extension is manifested in the sedimentary pile by horizontal shearing in the ductal level and notably in the evaporites of the trias. The strong rotation of the stress field observed in this block corresponds exactly to the period when important variation in the drifting of Africa and Europe are recorded. In fact, according to Dewey et al., 1989, after a noticeable slowing down and erratic movements of the two converging plates during Paleocene, Africa move again towards the knee precisely during late Eurasian around 51 Ma, anomaly 21. We are tempted to believe that this brutal change of behavior of the African plate was recorded in the late Eurasian faulting episode in this part of the Saharan platform and corresponds to the rotation of the detected stress fields. Terminal Eurasian movements on the borders of the Ousseltia block associated with NWSE the knee SW transtension, 1-2, successive extension direction at the end of Eurasian. At the end of the Eurasian, the Tunisian platform looked like a jigsaw puzzle made up of huge blocks limited by ancient fractures. The Ousseltia block is an example of this blocks. The remobilization of the block boundaries occurred in an extensive context. The stress field developed a strain within the blocks themselves that corresponds to the stress pattern. In this context, the material affected during lithification, reacted in an original way by developing a ductile slash fragile strain according to the rheological characteristic of the levels. This intra-block deformation appears superficial and space-limited compared to the one that can be seen on the block boundaries. It is immediately registered and memorized in the deposits and then sealed by successive sedimentation periods. The later stress fields which strained these blocks again caused a remobilization at the boundaries, more and less masking the earlier movements, and provoked new intra-block deformation which, on the contrary, will be fossilized. Thus, that is how a great number of paleostructures have been yielded to us nearly intact for observation since Jurassic. The example of the Ousultia block evolution at Late Eurasian may represent a model of the tectonic behavior of the Africa Plate in Tunisia during its pre-Alpine history. Finally, this geological structure, blocks, could correspond to a similar geodynamic context observed during Aption Crisis, northern Tethyan Transtensive and eastern Mesogean margins, Figure 9. Geodynamic context of Eurasian basin in Tunisia. This crisis is identified in central Tunisia by Yaik, 1984, 1997, and confirmed by Blondel, 1991. It is characterized by extension related to the western Mediterranean, Red Sea and Suez Gulf opening and Western Europe rifts genesis.